Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're going to go over what pseudostratified columnar epithelium is. The epithelium is the outer thin layer of tissue made up of a continuous layer of cells that lines the external surfaces of the body, the organs and blood vessels, in addition to the internal surfaces of the hollow organs within the body. There are several types of epithelium found lining the surfaces of the body. These can be distinguished based on a mixture of the number of layers of cells the epithelium is made up of and the shape of the epithelial cells. When the epithelium consists of only a single layer of epithelial cells, but the nuclei within the cell are arranged in a manner that would be seen in stratified epithelium, so not all in the same location, it is called pseudostratified. When the epithelial cells are elongated and the height of the cell is longer than the width, they are called columnar cells. Pseudostratified columnar epithelium is made up of a single layer of cells that are elongated and columnar in shape and of varying heights. The nuclei of adjacent cells do not line up in the same place, but instead in different locations, giving the appearance of more than one cell layer of being stratified. The single layer of cells sits on the basement membrane. There are two types of pseudostratified columnar epithelium, ciliated and non-ciliated. Ciliated pseudostratified columnar epithelium consists of a single layer of irregularly sized columnar cells that have cilia on the apical surface of the cells. Interspersed between the ciliated cells are the occasional modified columnar cells called goblet cells. These cells lack any cilia on the apical surface of the cell. These goblet cells primarily function in secretion. They secrete mucus that lubricates the internal surfaces of the parts of the body it is located in. Ciliated pseudostratified columnar epithelial cells are found lining most of the upper respiratory system, for example, lining the trachea. The ciliated cells function in moving mucus and foreign substances out towards the throat. Non-ciliated pseudostratified columnar epithelium have stereocilia on the apical surface of the cells instead of cilia. Stereocilia are non-motile protrusions. They are different to both cilia and microvilli, but are more closely related to microvilli. The importance of stereocilia is similar to that of microvilli in that they increase the surface area of the cell. This increased surface area is important as the main function of this type of epithelial cell is in absorption. Non-ciliated pseudostratified epithelium is found lining the vas deferens and epididymis of the male reproductive system. Here it functions in the absorption of excess fluid, causing the sperm to become more concentrated. Both the ciliated and non-ciliated forms function as a layer of protection against substances found on the lumen of the different organs it is found lining. The mucus secreted by goblet cells also helps in protecting the epithelium itself by removing foreign particles and pathogens from the upper respiratory tract. And that concludes this video on pseudostratified columnar epithelium. Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.